What is the hottest term in the AI community today? Of course, it's Seed Dream 4.0. This morning, I woke up and saw this image. A Superman hitting a large banana. I think the meaning behind this is quite clear to everyone. It refers to Seed Dream 4.0. Being able to outperform Nano Banana. Many people might be curious about what exactly Seed Dream 4.0 is. Actually, it's a new image generation model released by the ByteDance team. The capabilities of this model are extremely powerful. Therefore, in the community, many have offered various ways to use it. In this video, I will demonstrate nearly 20 different ways to use it, and each effect is absolutely stunning. If you currently want to use Seed Dream 4.0, the official way is only through Jimeng's official website. Jimeng's official website has an overseas version and a Chinese domestic version. Currently, this model is only available on the domestic version. The overseas version is not yet available. Everyone, open Jimeng's official website. Here, there's a menu called Generate. If we select Image Generation, we can choose the corresponding model. Please select Image 4.0, which has the corresponding explanation above, by Seed Dream 4.0. So, you are currently using the Seed Dream 4.0 model. Everyone, open Jimeng's official website. Here, there's a menu called Generate. If we select Image Generation, we can choose the corresponding model. Please select Image 4.0, which has the corresponding explanation above, by Seed Dream 4.0. So, you are currently using the Seed Dream 4.0 model. I once built a corresponding QuinImage workflow on Running Hub. You can visit this platform via runninghub.ai. On this platform, I built a standard QuinImage workflow. Next, let's paste the prompt we just copied. Then, let's run it and see the effect. You can see, this is the poster effect generated by QuinImage. The overall layout is consistent with our prompt. You don't need to look closely at the prompt. Next, let's use Seed Dream 4.02 generate with the same prompt. Let's paste the prompt here. We directly click Generate. Please note that when I paste it, you will notice that there's a character limit, which is less than 800 characters. So, I had to delete a part of it. Also, when generating images, try to choose smart ratio here. Look, this is the effect generated by Seed Dream, the overall sci-fi feel. The text layout and requirements are basically corresponding. Therefore, its generation capability is also quite strong. Of course, generation capability is just a small part of it. Next, let's look at its other capabilities. Here I have a sketch logo of a running horse. Then, I want it to use this logo as a trademark to generate some cultural product designs. For example, t-shirts, bracelets, and my trademark name is Gan Loss. I made some basic requests for the color. I requested it to be orange-yellow. Let's look at the generated effect. My key requirements were 3 points. First, the logo is a running horse. Second, I want Gan Loss as the trademark. Third, it should be orange-red. Then, I listed 3 products, namely t-shirts, bracelets, and a book. I didn't list it later. It simply designed a new logo, which I think is also good. Therefore, its product design capability is still very strong. Okay, next, let's look at the second example. I have 2 images here. The first image is a magazine cover. The second image is a person. Now, I want to use the person from the second image and replace the main character in the magazine cover. Then, let's generate it. Take a look at the effect. The person was perfectly replaced, but other elements remained unchanged. Okay, let's look at the next example. This example can be called expression transfer. Please note, I have 2 images here. The first image is a bust shot of a beautiful woman. The second is a close-up of a face. It's a girl pouting. So, I hope to transfer the expression of the second person to the first person. Therefore, my prompt requests that the person in image 1 changes their facial expression to be like that in image 2, and other parts should remain unchanged. Let's look at the generated effect. Ah, the girl's expression has become a pout. Some are more obvious, some might be slightly less so, but the overall feeling is fine. Next, let's look at a more complex example. Here, I have 3 images. The first image is an outfit with some accessories, including earrings, a watch, a bag, and shoes. The second image is a pose. The third image is the pouting photo we just used. I wrote a prompt. I hoped to generate an image like this. It uses the pose from image 2, the person from image 3, wearing the clothes from image 1, and other accessories. Looking at the generated effect, you will find that the girl's pouting state is also preserved. The 4 images have roughly similar basic forms. Let's look at the clothes. watch, earrings, then the bag and shoes. They are basically consistent with our reference images. Therefore, its reference-based generation capability is still very strong. But you need to be careful. Sometimes details like glasses can be lost. The latter two images have this problem. So, when there are many reference images, we might need to do some gacha. This example is actually a simplified version of the example above. Now, we just want to change the pose. So, I have an image here with a pose. And here's an image of a person. Next, let's see if its pose can be transferred very well. The prompt is also very simple. I will request the person in image 2 to strike a pose like the one in image 1. Take a look. The pose has some slight differences, but basically, there are no issues. A perfectly achieved pose transfer. But when doing this example, you need to pay attention. If the pose you provide is a full body one, then the image you provide should also ideally be full body. If the proportions are not quite right, situations like this might occur with the same pose image. If I give a bust image, the person's proportions are clearly distorted. This next one is amazing. Here, I have two images. The first one is a bodhisattva from Buddhist legends. The second one is actually a very beautiful jade cup. So what do I want to do now? I want to transfer the texture from image 2 to image 1. Let's take a look. The generated effect is absolutely stunning. The feeling of the character, the very solemn and dignified Buddhist figure's image, is preserved. But the texture is also perfectly transferred to it. Of course, there's a slight deviation. Because the cup just now was a jade cup, and this one feels a bit like celadon. But I think at this level, it's already excellent. Similarly, let's do another one. The first image is still this one. For the second image, I've changed it to a blue and white porcelain bowl. Let's see if it can be perfectly transferred. This one is very accurate. The consistency of the character, including the consistency of the material, is very well reflected. Next, let's look at light and shadow transfer. So now, I have an image like this. It was taken at dusk or at night. Then my second image looks like this. It's a very ordinary daytime photo. I want to transfer the light and shadow from the second image to the first one. Therefore, I can use such a prompt to achieve the corresponding effect. And everyone, look at this transfer effect. It's still very impressive. It beautifully simulates the texture of dusk and night, and even the feeling of the setting sun's light, all simulated very beautifully. Next, let's look at the effect of figurines. This effect, actually, in Nano Banana, it has already been overused. So, let's take a look at how it performs in Seed Dream 4.0. What its effect will be. My reference image is an image of a seated beautiful woman. Then my prompt says, transform this image into a character figure, and it needs to be placed on a round plastic base. Behind it, there should be a packaging box printed with the character, and a computer screen displaying a modeling effect using software like Blender. Such an effect. Let's look at the final generated effect. Compared to Nano Banana, what differences are there? The plastic base, the packaging box behind it, the Blender modeling process. All of these are present. Several images are similar. This next one is more complex. Let's look. There are four reference images. The first is a person wearing a fitted black long dress. The second is a cat. The third is a bag. The fourth is a living room scene. I think everyone knows what I'm going to do. I need this person to hold the cat from image 2 and carry the bag from image 3 and stand in the living room scene from image 4. Let's look at the generated effect. It's also very impressive. The consistency of the character and objects, including the cat and the overall scene, is very strong. This example is relatively simple. Here's an outfit design. Besides the clothes, there are also a bag and shoes. And of course, this is what we call virtual try-on. We want to put these clothes on an Asian woman. Let's look at the effect. Very beautiful. Four images, each with a different angle. But the consistency of items, the consistency of clothes, including shoes, all of these are fine. Ah, this example is very interesting. It's called very strong contextual understanding capability. So here I first have a reference image. This reference image is actually an image of a temple. Don't mind what it is, we just need to know it's daytime. Then, my prompt states that if 11 hours pass, the entire scene changes. 11 hours would definitely make it night. Let's look at the generated effect. This is the scene change at night. Perhaps the four images only differ in some lighting and shadows, but the overall scene atmosphere is completely fine. We also have another example here that can also demonstrate its powerful contextual perception ability. Look at this image. It shows two girls standing in front of a swimming pool. Behind them is an abandoned school. This looks rather eerie. And notice how I wrote the prompt. I wanted to generate an image where the perspective is looking from behind the previous image. We also have another example here that can also demonstrate its powerful contextual perception ability. Look at this image. It shows two girls standing in front of a swimming pool. Behind them is an abandoned school. This looks rather eerie. And notice how I wrote the prompt. I wanted to generate an image where the perspective is looking from behind the previous image. So, these are the powerful image generation capabilities we've demonstrated to everyone regarding Seed Dream's powerful image generation capabilities and reference-based generation capabilities. You'll find that we can't say it completely crushes Nano Banana, but at the very least, it's not worse than Nano Banana, right? Hey, what are you waiting for? Go try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.